University is the first time often that you'll be living independently. I trained at UEA, so in the end I decided that I wasn't going to pay to go into walls, so I did stay at home for the first few years until my wife finished her, my wife now girlfriend at the time, finished her course at UEA. She was studying at Chester. One thing to bear in mind, if any of you are already in a relationship or couples, think about where universities are in relation to one another. Norwich and Chester are quite a long way away from one another. I used to spend 6 hours on the train every other weekend going to visit her. That was quite challenging. But yes, independent living. So you might be responsible for, let's say, cooking. You might be living in accommodation. So it's not quite like Hogwarts, but think sort of boarding school. So you might share accommodation with several other students. You might be in flats together. There might be 6 or 8 of you in a flat, so you might share a kitchen, have your own sort of bed spaces. When you're looking at accommodation, think about sort of cost versus what you get. So you might live in a slightly slummier flat that doesn't have your own ensuite, but it's cheaper. So you have to weigh out these things as a student and see what's more important to you. And then later on, generally after the first year, most people will move out of university accommodation and will live in a rented house with other students. So that's sort of the thing that most people do, because the universities only provide accommodation to you for the first year. So that accommodation might be catered or self-catered. You might decide whether you want to cook for yourself, or you want to have a first year if you're not worrying about that, if your university offers catering. Some do, some don't. You might want to think about, and that might be where distance is important. So a lot of you, if you do want to go far away from mum and dad, remember you might think you're not going to feel homesick, but often you will. So if you do go miles and miles away, think about how long it's going to take you to get back home, if you do want to come back and see mum and dad, or if you want to bring them a bag of washing, which I'm sure they'll be delighted with at the weekend, then think about how far away you are from where your home is. Socialising is often an important part of university life, because instead you're going to be meeting new groups of people. Medical schools are often reasonably large. I think there's about 150 of us in each year group at UEA. So they're quite large sort of cohorts of students. You will get to know a lot of them in that time. And there'll be a lot of events to try and help you get to meet new people and socialise. And actually the medical schools themselves tend to be quite prolific in organising those. One thing about medicine, unfortunately, sometimes it can be a little bit of its own, on its own limb. Medical students tend to study for a lot longer than other students. You don't get such long holidays because the terms tend to be longer. So that's, think about that when you want to study it. You still get reasonably good holiday, but not as much because you're only on placement. Nurses get very little holiday at all. The nursing students work very hard and they do very long placements. So actually you find that nursing students probably have less holiday than you have now at school, possibly, if not about the same maybe. But lots of degree courses do have quite long holidays because you're expected to do a lot of self-directed learning, reading around. So if you study history, for example, or drama, then you'll often be finishing very early, long summer break. So that's the nature of the courses at the moment. Exams. So I'm afraid that exams don't finish when you finish school, then they get worse. University and medical school, you generally will have exams throughout the year and assessments throughout the year, and then you generally have a big written paper at the end of each year, and you might also have some clinical exams where you have to pretend to examine patients or do mock examinations, mock histories for patients. So there is a lot of examination in medical school, and in any degree you'll have things to do, and they'll expect you to do reading around outside your course and other things.